So I will create a log house with this kind of notch. So it can called Salmon tail notch. So we can see that this height plus this height should be a little bit less than the two height of the logs, because there is a junction here. So, and you can see here, this is the plane. So it goes down the same amount on each side. And the same thing on the other side, it's a plane. And also this angle makes that, this angle down makes this log stay in place. So all the angles make that it's gonna make the house hold for itself. So we go to front view and create a Bezier curve. I make it 15 centimeters. Like this. If you see from the top view, it's like that. We make all the control points and scale. Right. Scale by 0. So, and I will just move this one. Snap here, increment. I make all the control points free, like this. Now I'll just shape the. I use like 3 centimeters by 3. Oh, I think it's good. So this is the shape I want. I see here it's 15 centimeters and 24.5 centimeters. So this is good, and I will convert that to a mesh. And you can see now there is a lot of control points here. So I'll just remove them. Scale is at 0. We'll use so now we'll just you see here I'm in solid mode now, and I will just fill this face. So you see it's 3 meters now, and yeah, it's we'll smooth shade it like this, and you can see it's not really what we want, so there is a normals here which is 30 degrees. So this is what we want, and I will make a mirror. I will make a boolean now. So I create another cube. And now it's 15 centimeters. So I will just center it. And I know that the half of 15 is 7.5, so just like this. So now we have a cube, and we will make the plane. So if you look here again, you see that this point is the highest. We choose, for example, this point. This is the highest point, and the point beside it goes down 1 centimeter, and this goes down one from that one, and this goes down which one. So you see here it's a plane like this, and it's all in the same angle, for example, like this one. So we make a boolean on this. You can see that we remove the top thing here. And now so make the same things here. You can go back to wireframe mode. So I think it's good that it's centered here. So this point is, you can say it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 centimeters up. So we make this 6 centimeters down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So yeah, it's good where it is now. And this shows this point. It has to go up 1 centimeters. This point here, so go up. So this is the angle we want. Go back in this view, and the important thing here was that the inner, the small edge has to be, yeah, because it is the same here and here. So it has to be a little bit less than 2 logs on top of each other. So for example, go back to this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's 10 centimeters. So it will be 20. Yeah, it's a bit too little. We will just move this one up one step and this down one step. Like this. And now we have we have a shape which is good. But you can see here there is some artifacts because this, I have to move this point a little bit. So now it's good. So I'll make a copy of this one, and I will apply the boolean. So I can remove this one. So I have this shape, and I will create a mirror of it also. So I will move the origin. So make a mirror modifier, and then if you look here in wireframe mode, you see there is a edge here in the middle. I will just show you how a log is bent. I'll move this one snap to vertex. Oh, first of all, apply this. So then I will choose the just this edge and the subdivide like 10 times maybe. And then we can, so we'll create an empty here, plane X, snap it here, and move it here, rotate it a little bit. So I will use a bend modifier here, simple deform bend. Just to show you how a log could look like, but yeah, something like that. This is a little bit exaggerated, so we have to remove this one like this. This is the shape of a log. So it becomes this is the root and this is the top, and there is always a curvature, because when you use a log, you use the rounding up and down, so you have the two sides here are, otherwise if you saw the round log, you cannot get like a nice shape here. So it has to be like the rounding is in this X here. So this is just to show you that you can use the rounding here. So we'll just duplicate this one more time and apply. We apply this also, so, and now we'll move the origin back here, for example. This we can hide. So I make a duplicate. You can see here it's not matching the shape. It has to do with it has to be matched maybe here. Yeah, here we're too much, so we just choose the origin here. So this is a log here, we're happy with that, and here we duplicate in the Z. So now we're happy with that, the this shape is what we want, so just have to duplicate like that. So now I'm happy with this angle. If you look back here, you see that here it's like every log is different, and here for simplicity we make this one just to be regular like that, and then we can make a side, and then we can just mirror it, so we get the four walls. So this is a way of modeling a log house.